let's learn how to compute the three measures of central tendency, mean, median, and mode, using JASP. For this example, we will use the dataset StatsClass.SAV. Begin by placing the dataset on your computer desktop. Once you have JASP open, we will open the file by going to our main menu icon, Open, Computer, Desktop. Locate the StatsClass.SAV dataset and click Open. Notice that this is actually an SPSS dataset. JASP can open a .sav file directly, as well as CSV datasets, but not an Excel file. Those have to be converted into CSV first. As you can see, JASP has read the file and is showing you the data. We are interested in the variables IQ, a measure of intelligence, and StatAt, or a measure of attitudes about statistics. JASP has correctly interpreted the level of measurement for both of these variables as scale, so we are ready to go. Central tendency is a descriptive statistic, so we will be using this Descriptives menu. Select the option for Descriptive Statistics. In the Results pane, we already see the table where the descriptive statistics are going to appear. Move the variables standardized IQ scores, or IQ, and attitudes towards statistics, or StatAt, into the variables box. Here we see the JASP progressive disclosure. The results appear as soon as we enter the variables. However, we do not yet have all of the measures of central tendency that we will need, but it's easy enough to add them. Click on the disclosure triangle next to statistics. Here we find a list of available statistics for our variables. We want mean, median, and mode. As we click on them, each measure of central tendency is added to our existing descriptive statistics table. Because this introductory lecture is only about central tendency, we have measures of dispersion that we do not need right now. To turn off any option, we simply deselect the box. Of course, as we put these statistical pieces together moving forward, we will always want to combine our measures of central tendency with a measure of dispersion, and we will do that in all future examples. Now we can examine the results. Our first variable is standardized IQ scores. Look at the mean, median, and mode. 97.69, 97.3, and 97.3. Now look at the attitudes towards statistics scores. This time, the mean, median, and mode are 5.64, 6, and 1. So here is my question for you. Which of these two variables is normally distributed? And how can you tell? The key is to look at the three measures of central tendency. The mean, median, and mode for IQ scores are very, very similar. Whereas for attitudes towards statistics, these three measures of central tendency are not even close. This tells us that attitude is not normally distributed, but IQ is normally distributed. But let's prove this to ourselves. It could be helpful to see a histogram of both of these distributions to get a sense for how they look. Click the disclosure triangle next to Plots. We would like to see the distribution plots. This shows us some histograms. We can get even more information by adding the density of the distribution. We now see the results. I said that IQ scores should be normally distributed based on the fact that the mean, median, and mode were almost the same. And what do we see? The density curve for IQ scores looks pretty much like a normal curve. We clearly have an outlier or two on the upper end, but otherwise, density looks normal. It would be rare that a distribution looks exactly like a normal curve, but this is close enough to a normal distribution. In fact, we might say that this distribution satisfies the assumption of normality. It is approximately normally distributed. But what about attitude towards statistics? We said that that would not be normally distributed, so let's check it out. Notice that neither the histogram nor the density curve looks anything like a normal curve. Normality is something that we can see both mathematically and with pictures. Both the numbers and the plot agree. This variable is not normally distributed. So as a bonus, let me show you a few other things that you can do with JASP. With progressive disclosure, it is easy to add plots or analyses. So for example, let's add the correlation plots. Here we see a correlation of our two variables. Not surprisingly, IQ and stats attitudes are weakly positively correlated. And we see some other familiar distribution plots. Now, the great thing about JASP is that you can add new analyses or plots, and you never need to worry that you're going to break something. For example, let's look at the box plots. The box plots do not tell us as much about the shape of the distribution as the histogram did, but they do show us the spread or the dispersion, and they help us identify outliers. Remember, we said that there were some outliers with the IQ scores. If we label the outliers, we can learn their case numbers. We can also add color, a violin element, and what is called a jitter element that allows us to see the data points more clearly. We will learn more about these elements later, but for now, feel free to experiment with turning on or off the output. Down here, we have QQ plots. These plots help us to determine the normality of a distribution. If the dots are on a straight line, the variable is normally distributed, as we see here with IQ. But if the dots are off of the line, as with statistics attitude, the variable is not normally distributed. I think that I want to keep the QQ plots, but I do not want the box plots or the correlation plots. I simply deselect those boxes and the results go away. Or if I change my mind, I can add them back easily. One more thing. Let's look at that table again. JASP makes it easy to split an analysis by a categorical variable. So let's say that we want to examine the scores for males and females separately. Move the variable gender into the split box. Now we can see the same central tendency results, except separated by scores for males and females. We could do the same thing for a categorical variable with multiple levels, such as class standing, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. Finally, you can save this file as a JASP dataset by going to Save As, Computer, Desktop, and saving it as StatsClass. The new file will appear on your desktop as StatsClass.JASP. Not only will it contain your numeric data, it will also contain all of the analysis and the plotting that you have done so far. So this is how you calculate central tendency in JASP.